On January 12th, Delta Airlines announced that it was ordering 20 Airbus A350-1000s. When they enter service, the aircraft will be the largest type operating in Delta's fleet. The jets look to be the carrier's flagship type, complete with its highest-end premium products. Interestingly, with the addition of the A350-1000, Delta will operate much of Airbus's in-production aircraft, from the small Airbus A220-100 to the A350-1000. So, while the other major US carriers seem to be more Boeing-heavy, why does Delta buck the trend and go with aircraft from the European plane maker? Let's find out for today's video. When it comes to Airbus's commercial aircraft lineup, Delta appears to have collected most aircraft families. The airline operates both variants of the A220. From the A320 family, it operates the CEO versions of the A319, A320 and A321, and the A321neo. From the A330 family, it operates the -200, -300 and -900. And finally, with the A350, the -900 is currently its flagship jet, although the -1000 will appear in 2026, according to Reuters. When you look at the airline's fleet composition, it's quite clear that Delta was not blindly ordering whatever Airbus was offering. Indeed, the carrier has avoided Airbus jets with poor operating economics, such as the A318, A319neo, A330-800 and A380. Not only are these variants absent from its fleet, but they have also proved or are proving to be rather unpopular worldwide, selling well below Airbus's targets. When we look at Delta's US rivals, there is a heavy leaning towards Boeing aircraft, particularly when it comes to wide-bodies. American Airlines' wide-body fleet is all Boeing, with the 787 Dreamliner and 777. United Airlines has a similar setup and notably has all three variants of the 787, with potentially hundreds more of these wide-bodies on order when options are counted. The narrow-body side is a little different, as all three legacy carriers operate jets from both the 737 family and the A320 family. Even Delta announced in 2022 that it would be adding 100 examples of the 737 MAX 10 to its fleet, with options for 30 more. Nonetheless, it is clear that Delta stands out from its rivals as the only US carrier to have ordered the A330neo and A350. While JetBlue Airways and Breeze Airways have chosen the A220 to be core parts of their fleets, neither American nor United have looked at adding the Canadian-designed jet. So, is Delta's decision to order more Airbus aircraft a sign that the carrier is un-American or doesn't support American industry? Is there an anti-Boeing bias? Going down this path of thinking appears to make things more complicated than they actually are. The carrier is ultimately focused on finding the best aircraft for its fleet, rather than being loyal to one manufacturer, whether it be the local favorite or a foreign company. It's worth noting that historically, Delta was a major Boeing operator. The airline has operated the 747 and 777 and continues to operate the 717, 737, 757 and 767. Much of Delta's A330 fleet was inherited from its merger with Northwest Airlines. Pleased with the type, the carrier went on to order more. This could be seen as the airline's major turning point and shift from Boeing to Airbus. In a 2015 statement marking the delivery of the first Delta-ordered A330-300, the airline said, "The new A330-300s are 15-25% more fuel-efficient per seat than the Boeing 767-300s and 747-400s they will replace." In the same statement, CEO Ed Bastian noted that Delta's addition of this Airbus A330-300 reflects the airline's continued strategy of making prudent investments in our fleet that enhance our customer experience and operational reliability. With all of this in mind, the airline's subsequent orders for the A330-900 made sense due to the type's high degree of commonality with the older generation A330. Regarding the A350, Air Cargo Week quoted Bastian saying the new flagship aircraft fits well in Delta's long-haul network, combining an exceptional customer experience with strong operating economics and fuel efficiency. Additionally, Airbus noted that the A330 Common Type rating allows pilots to transition from A330 to A350 in only 8 days without full flight simulator sessions. This enables carriers to use a single fleet flying concept with a pool of pilots qualified for both aircraft, providing increased scheduling flexibility and mobility, the European planemaker stated. Now, in 2024, with the airline ready for another round of growth and renewal, the A350-1000 was the obvious choice to fly alongside the existing Airbus wide-body fleet. Quoted in a media statement put out by Airbus, Bastian said that the largest A350 variant complements our fleet and offers an elevated customer experience with more premium seats and best-in-class amenities, as well as expanded cargo capabilities. With the carrier having retired its fleet of Boeing 777-200LRs, it would not make sense to go back to this aircraft type. At the same time, the 777-9 would be several years away, while again not complementing the airline's existing wide-body fleet. On the narrow-body side, the adoption of the A220 is another great example of non-partisanship. Delta committed to the A220 when it was still the Bombardier C-Series. As the airline was eager to determine a replacement for its aging 717s, Boeing did not have any new planes that could compete. Speaking with Airways magazine, Bastian said that Delta needed to, quote, find something that's going to be more fuel efficient, something that's going to create a greater range and a greater bandwidth of options, and the Series A220 fit the bill. At the same time, it's worth noting that Delta had an outstanding order for 787s at one point. This was a deal initially struck between Boeing and Northwest and was inherited by Delta. As it was cancelled several years after the merger, the move made sense as the carrier had already placed large wide-body orders with Airbus. On this topic, a Delta executive told Business Insider that the decision was, quote, consistent with Delta's fleet strategy to prudently address our wide-body aircraft needs. Proving that Delta still values Boeing products, the carrier placed an order for 100 737 MAX 10s in July 2022. Again, this order complements the airline's existing fleet, particularly as it currently operates 240 737s. With the 737 fleet being a mix of -800s and -900ERs, the future arrival of MAX 10s will fit perfectly in terms of training and maintenance. The bottom line is that Delta is modernizing its fleet with Airbus aircraft simply because it considers them the best options to replace out-of-production Boeing aircraft such as the 717, 757, and 767. The 787 and 777X families were always going to be unlikely candidates, with the carrier having already chosen Airbus widebodies for higher capacity long-haul operations. Now very much invested in Airbus jets for this segment of its operations, the bias towards the European planemaker's widebodies is likely to continue for the sake of fleet compatibility. Do you think Delta has chosen wisely with its Airbus-heavy fleet composition? Share your thoughts by leaving a comment. Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.